Who am I, you ask? I'm a basketball player who went from slam dunks to becoming a slam poet. To realizing that the rhythm was always deep down in my soul, it just took me a while to fully know it. Cause just like basketball, sometimes someone passes you the rock and you put on the spot. And sometimes your shot goes cold, and sometimes you got that big head like an NBA Jam cause you're just so hot. And I'm a black coal placed in this world's fire and metamorphosis to become a diamond robot. Cause unlike Rice Krispies, I'm never a square. Cause I got that vocab that'll make ya snap, crackle, pop, and lock. They call me the Rasta alien, the Nazi dreaded intellectual Spock. I've always been on a mission to beam us all up like Scotty. And they be like, oh, there he go again with that rapture talk. You see, there was a time in my life when I had a lot of money, but then I blew out my knee like my boy Shane Denny. It was my left ACL. And after that, it was T-I-M-E to kill, time to kill. Doctor, doctor, please don't give me no more pills, because it seems like these days, that's where CNN bombers and mass shooters go to get their thrills. And I want my head awake and eyes clear, so don't pill me up and disguise it as Everclear, because I will never let that smooth taste fool me. And did I mention, there was a time when I was almost famous. The writing was on the wall, but the back of my jersey was nameless. It was like when I was a kid, and they were picking teams, and I was still standing there with the wall kicking rocks, aimless. So now they call me off the wall. And when I tell you this, you'll probably call me sensitive, because sticks and stones, they broke my bones. But the words are not good enough, those will always hurt me. But then I eventually realized the best teams, they never have names on the back. It's just like how a pack of wolves, they only got their pack. And I'm a pack of nerds poured into a Coke bottle then shook up till I bust out, burst through the peer pressure and realized I was somewhat immune to the peer pressure. And yes, I was the type of kid who did stuff like that because it's always been my pleasure. Somewhere along the lines, I found my happiness in earth and treasures. But at the same time, I didn't recognize the gift. I only acknowledged the curse because that's the only way that I can explain that before I started flying all over the world, I was so much more down to earth. So I guess it's safe to assume that for me being away from my friends and family for 9 months in the year made me feel like I was in a hearse. But what job do you know allows you to see the world? Merrily going around like your wind's on a whirl and have a love for an orange leather ball that only rivals your beautiful girl. My mind swirls like a mummy when it's wrapped in a tomb as I slowly pay homage to the boom booms. Cause not a day goes by. Not a day goes by when I don't think about it all. In all my life, I've been looking for love like this as I stare into my beautiful son's eyes and give my wife a long affectionate kiss. A kiss so magical it makes the jigsaws of our mouths and noses kiss and kiss away them memories of a lifetime long ago that I like to still fondly reminisce. But I'm really just up on this stage trying to hit you with dope thoughts that'll make your spirit move. When you stand up out of them seats, walk out that door and into the next room, or maybe the next time you're standing in silence staring at the moon. It don't matter if you believe in the Bible or the big boom, if you just take the time out. Time out, ref, time out to think about it.